shimmer of the river, you can see the lights of Harlem and the gorse among the salt piles along the FDR. You can hear the heavy footsteps of the overworked and weary. Once upon a midnight dream, he was standing where you are. He wandered through Manhattan, searching for his true beloved. Even though her worldly burden long lay buried in the earth, he sacrificed his scruples in an attempt to resurrect her in the fundamental rhythm of death. Allan Poe lived his last days in the Bronx. He lived his last days in the Bronx, but he died in Baltimore. He died in Baltimore. In Baltimore. And in a raging fever, he was sure he saw a spirit among the ghosts and phantoms forever between trains. Her face was pale and hollow, but her eyes lit up in flashes as the snowflakes on her lashes fell upon her harbor chains. And he heard the holy music, the bells of New York City, where the loneliness and pity took him to the tavern floor. And in a hollow whisper, he said, "Tell me, pilgrim shadow, why do we aim for El Dorado just to die in Baltimore?" Edgar Allan Poe lived his last days in the Bronx. He lived his last days in the Bronx, but he died in Baltimore. He died in Baltimore. In Baltimore. They found him in a coma. His clothes had all been stolen, replaced by a black alpaca and ragged gabardine. And all the people in the tavern, they swore that he left sober, even though it was October, only days from Halloween.
No one ever did discover the seeds of his destruction, be it alcohol or opium, typhus or TB. Or maybe he got shanghaied on some street obscure and lonely, haunted by dark angels only, down to the sound. Thank you.